the new Alcon Clarion intraocular lens. In this video, you will learn what distinguishes the new Clarion from the old, well-known Akrisoff, what intermediate vision quality can be expected with the monofocal Alcon Clarion. We will definitely talk about astigmatism treatment with the toric Clarion, and even touch on the topic of presbyopic lenses, like Vivity Clarion and Panoptics Clarion. Hi there, my name is Oleksiy at IOL Advisor Channel, telling the truth about IOLs. Clarion is the name of the new material, the new hydrophobic acrylic developed by Alcon, which for about the last couple of years has gradually started to be used in all of the brand's intraocular lenses. Previously, for about 20 years, Alcon made all its intraocular lenses based on another material, which was called Akrisoff. So, previously, the entire Akrisoff lineup was simply the name of the material used for standard spherical monofocal lenses, aspheric monofocal lenses, as well as presbyopic lenses, Restore, Panoptics, and later Vivity. The Clarion material, like the Akrisoff material, is a hydrophobic acrylic. But the question is, why exactly did Alcon change the material? There's no official information about this, although many in the industry, and I also believe, it's related to the fact that the previous Akrisoff material, despite being quite high quality and having millions of lenses implanted over the last 20 years, sometimes showed small vacuoles inside the lenses. I mentioned this in a previous video, and this was an occasional issue, not for everyone, but it affected the quality of vision, and it wasn't clear when or how it would manifest. Now, according to Alcon, this material will be of better quality without these problems. Well, time will tell, but as of today, there have been no reports of these phenomena occurring. But what we definitely know is that neither the optical design nor the haptic design, the elements that attach the lens to the eye, have changed in Alcon's entire lineup. So, this applies to spherical, aspheric, monofocal lenses, any toric modifications, Vivity, Panoptics, Clarion, and Akrisoff lenses, which are optically identical. If we know that the lenses haven't changed optically, then, in fact, we could end this review right here. Because the review of monofocal lenses is already available on the channel, the review of presbyopic lenses like Vivity and Panoptics is also on the channel, the review of toric lenses is also on the channel. I've talked about the materials, so there's not much to discuss. But, friends, there is one important nuance that specifically concerns the monofocal Alcon Clarion. So, I think it's important for us to dig deeper and figure out what's there and what you should expect if you're going to have the monofocal Alcon Clarion implanted. So, let's dive in. First, let's Google Alcon Clarion monofocal lens. Here is an official Alcon website. So what can we pay attention to? Intermediate vision, functional intermediate vision at mid-range distance. Interesting. Once again, maximum sharpness of vision, predicted results, and again, functional vision at mid-range distance. There are some references, and then there's even a table with some sharpness data, and it says, once again, predicted intermediate vision at mid-range distances. It all sounds quite interesting and promising because intermediate vision is a crucial element, of course, after distant vision. This is very important for a person's functional life in today's world. And probably, I would never have paid attention to these statements from Alcon on the website if colleagues hadn't started reaching out to me with questions. They were saying something like, Alcon released a new monofocal Clarion lens, and it somehow improves intermediate vision, but no one can explain how it works. It seems like the material changed, but what else exactly changed, we don't understand. Maybe you know something and can figure it out. And of course, I figured it out. And when I figured it out, on the one hand, I was a little surprised, but on the other hand, not so much. So now I'll tell you exactly what I figured out. And to understand what I figured out, let's start with intermediate vision. So, what is intermediate vision? Intermediate vision is vision at a distance of about 45 to 80 centimeters or 20 to 40 inches from the eyes. And it's typically measured at around 66 centimeters, as the standard at negative 1.5 diopters of defocus. Let's skip these details here. So it's something like plus minus the extended arm distance. Next, what is functional vision, which is mentioned here a bit? First, let's recall what visual acuity is. And visual acuity is not plus 2 or minus 3 or something like that. Visual acuity is the ability to read 10 lines on the distance chart. And actually, we have similar charts for intermediate and near vision. I guess you know all this. And what is functional vision? Here's where it gets interesting. functional vision is half of the norm. That means it's approximately 0.5, or roughly speaking, 5 lines or 50%. This is the threshold below which a person cannot function normally without external assistance. This level of visual acuity is when a person will better say, "I can't see," rather than trying to see something. So now it's a bit clearer what functional vision is and what distance is being discussed. Let's return to the marketing materials. As you can see here, they claim 20-30 seconds of visual acuity. It's about 0.2 in logMAR, evident from the screen. The key word here is up to, meaning no more, could be less. This is important. As you can see, this is where the statement about functional intermediate vision appears. And it seems all fair. There's the distance, there's visual acuity. All good. But the question is it really fair? And on the one hand, yes, because it truly meets the criteria for functional vision. But there's a nuance. Can you imagine Apple promoting the new iPhone in 2025 by highlighting its wireless Bluetooth capability when every other smartphone on the market has had it as a basic feature for years? But if that may happen, imagine what's the pitch. This is the same story in this case. Because a visual acuity of 0.2 on the logarithmic scale at 66 centimeters is the standard visual acuity provided by any monofocal lens, without exception. And to prove this, let's check what clinical data shows for Tecnis Eyhance and regular monofocal Tecnis, to see what exactly is provided by another regular monofocal lens. We'll take the clinical data comparing monofocal Tecnis and Eyhance. The gray histogram represents the visual acuity of monofocal Tecnis. It's 0.2 logMAR, and we see the same 0.2 on the Alcon website. 0.2 is the logarithmic scale, which means approximately 20-30 seconds or less, so the same visual acuity. So, 0.2 on the logarithmic scale is standard vision for a monofocal lens at 66 centimeters, and Eyhance in turn gives 0.1 on the logarithmic scale, or 0.8 on the decimal scale, meaning more than 1 up to 2 extra lines, depending on personality. Here it's important to add that a visual acuity of 0.2 with a monofocal lens and 0.1 with Eyhance are the best results achieved, and you may encounter different visual acuities. For example, not 0.2 with a monofocal lens, but 0.3 to 0.4, including binocular. And visual acuity with Eyhance may not be 0.1, but 0.2. But the main thing is that this difference of 1.5 lines will always remain in favor of Eyhance. This is something you'll always see everywhere. As you can see, the Tecnis Eyhance lens, which has been on a market for more than 5 years, indeed improves intermediate vision way more than one line. And this is a lot. If you're in an optician's office, you can notice this when you're checking your vision. How much even a difference of one line means? It's really significant. If you can't see it, ask them to adjust the test lenses a bit to see how your whole life and world will change when you change your visual acuity by one line. It's a very significant difference. And, in fact, this significant difference is what sets apart enhanced monofocal lenses, like Tecnis Eyhance from standard monofocal lenses, and why these two types of monofocal lenses are fundamentally different. That is, there are standard monofocal lenses with a minimal depth of focus, and then there are enhanced monofocal lenses with a larger depth of focus in this zone, which do not allow reading, and then there are presbyopic lenses. Well, you already know this from my videos. If we go back to my words when I said at the beginning of the video that some things surprised me and some things didn't, it actually concerns how Alcon communicates its marketing materials. I honestly wasn't at the presentation of the monofocal Alcon Clarion. I didn't hear it personally, but I was at the presentation of the presbyopic Alcon Vivity when they announced from the stage at a scientific conference that Alcon Vivity improves contrast sensitivity. This really surprised me back then, because I was already familiar with this lens, and I knew that it even said in the instructions that it reduces contrast sensitivity compared to monofocal lenses, yet here was this bold statement, Vivity improves contrast sensitivity. I even asked the speakers a question, got some strange answer, and the conference continued, and it's a shame that some consultants carried this information afterward, because no one will check what was said from the stage. They said it improves contrast sensitivity. They said this lens provides functional intermediate vision. Sounds great. This was from the stage, with even some invited speakers. And then you just pass it on and don't check the information. And actually, when it comes to Vivity, they didn't blatantly lie. because Vivity really does improve contrast sensitivity if you look at the MTF compared to Panoptix, but they didn't elaborate on it. Or maybe it was written in small print somewhere. The same is true here. In fact, Clarion, like any monofocal lens, provides functional vision at intermediate distances. I mentioned in my previous videos that you will see at any distance, but the quality of this vision may not satisfy you. And most often it doesn't, so you'll see close up, but very, very poorly. You'll see at intermediate distances. Well, it's not bad, but functionally. By functional criteria. It's just that many people may not be satisfied with this functionality, and at distance. So this is the art of presenting information. And returning to the question of what exactly surprised me, it's the fact that in the instructions, which are also publicly available, if we take the instructions for Akrisoft, for Clarion, nothing special is mentioned about intermediate vision. Here I downloaded the official instructions for Clarion and Akrisoft. I read them carefully and even searched by keywords. Enhanced, improved vision, intermediate vision. And as you can see, there's nothing about intermediate vision in either the Clarion or Akrisoft instructions. Moreover, the optical type in Akrisoft and Clarion is exactly the same, which confirms the initial statement on the website that Akrisoft and Clarion are optically identical lenses. So, there's no doubts that no intermediate vision is expected. And if we compare with the instructions for Eyhance, the instructions for Eyhance clearly state that this lens is designed to improve intermediate vision. It says that it is designed to extend the depth of focus, which improves intermediate vision. That is, the lens has a front surface designed to increase the depth of focus, which improves intermediate vision compared to standard aspheric monofocal lenses. And the difference between marketing materials and instructions is that in the instructions, you can't just throw around words like that, because they can later be held accountable. Instructions are written very carefully and calibrated, so to speak, by medical professionals, according to the clinical data provided by the medical product. Marketing has a certain degree of control, but there's more flexibility. That's how it goes. Anyway, in summary, Alcon gets the highest score for marketing, and honesty is up to you. So, let's summarize the video. The Alcon Clarion monofocal lens is a standard monofocal lens that is identical to the standard Akrisoft lens. So, when it comes to monofocal lenses, whether Akrisoft or Clarion, they are optically identical in terms of visual acuity for distance and near intermediate vision. If, for some reason, you need a strictly monofocal lens, then Alcon Clarion is a high-quality alternative to any cheap lenses, I mean, cheap monofocal lenses, and I always say it's better to choose Tecnis Eyhance for a wider range of vision. Because the intraocular lens is implanted once and for life, and the lens you choose will determine how you'll see. Now a few words about astigmatism treatment and toric intraocular lenses. As I've said many times, a toric lens doesn't improve the range of vision. It only improves the quality of vision for someone with astigmatism. Therefore, if you have astigmatism greater than 1 diopter, I believe you should consider a toric lens, although this should always be discussed with your doctor, because a toric lens for treating astigmatism is a medical indication. And if you, as a patient, don't have medical restrictions, you can choose either a monofocal or enhanced monofocal, or a full-range, trifocal, hybrid, any lens, but you can't choose a toric lens on your own. You can't just say, I want a toric, or I don't want a toric because I don't want to overpay. Toricity and astigmatism treatment are separate topics, and I'll have more videos on this on the channel, by the way, about the specifics of toric lens implantation, so don't forget to subscribe right now. Click the bell and leave your comments. So, Alcon toric lenses, whether Akrisoft or Clarion, are of good quality. I don't see any obstacles to using them if they're needed, and you can be sure that they are high quality and correct astigmatism well. The only thing is that they need to be properly calculated, just like any lens. Moving on. Clarion Vivity and Clarion Panoptix. Well, as I said, optically these lenses are all the same. Bonus pack, take a look at these data on Vivity and Panoptix. Which one is better? If we're talking about better contrast sensitivity, if you choose only between these two lenses, I'm not talking about other alternatives available on the market, but between these two lenses, Vivity definitely has better contrast sensitivity than Panoptix. And Panoptix has higher near vision acuity than Vivity. Significantly higher. And in this case, the material didn't affect contrast sensitivity. So, all the data on defocus curves, that is, visual acuity at different distances, Vivity, Panoptics, and even Monofocal Clarion, and Contrast Sensitivity MTF, all this data is essentially the same, because the optics of the lenses didn't change. That's what you need to know about Clarion, about the new Clarion intraocular lenses, about this new platform. So, in conclusion of this video, Alcon Clarion is a new material platform, but the optics and lens design are the same. The material is expected to be better in terms of long-term stability. And in fact, that's the only change. If you need astigmatism treatment, use toric lenses, talk to your doctor, and honestly, if your doctor suggests a toric lens, it's worth doing. The main thing is that you consciously choose lenses, so you understand exactly what's behind each model. And that's why I have detailed reviews of all intraocular lenses on my channel. Vivity, Synergy, PureSee, and many more. Use the search function, ask questions in the comments, and I wish you good vision.